How do you enjoy North America so far?
Yeah, it's great. We always said that, actually just when we got into Canada yesterday, we said that you get a really good feel, a really good vibe in Canada. I don't know what it is, like, I can't put my finger on it, but everyone just seems quite friendly, and I don't know, it's just, it's a cool place.
How do you handle all the love you get?
I don't know, really. I think just we kind of just go with it, and, you know, things like that, you know, you hear it, and actually it's not until you like lay down in bed and actually think about what's going on until it really hits you. I mean, people, you know, camping out overnight for us is just, it still seems so surreal, really.
Your the album that you can see right there, Up All Night, it arrived at number one the minute, probably the second it dropped, it was number one, beating records by the Beatles, the Spice Girls, Coldplay. How did you get that news?
I was in New York and I'd been out with my girlfriend, and then we'd just came back to get changed. I think we were going out to watch a music or something, and then got a call from our manager and he was like, you've done it, you've gone to number one. And when we knew the album was going to be released in America and Canada, we were like, oh, we think it'd be amazing if we got a top 10 album. Like, that would have just been incredible. But to go and debut at number one, you know, and break all those records is just such an honor.
It seems like pretty hectic. Your life is probably like crazy. Every second is planned, booked in advance. How do you make sure that you enjoy every piece, every second of it?
I think it's just, you know, especially with us, we kind of don't take things too seriously. You know, we just have fun, and everywhere we go, we just try and, you know, we're pretty mischievous, and we kind of just, I don't know, really. We just try and have fun and not let it go to our heads, you know, and just be, you know what I mean.
What do you think is the one sparkle, little sparkle, that makes you that popular, makes you the boy band out there right now?
I think maybe because we're not like, we're not following the stereotype like of boy bands, you know, the really clean cut, coordinating colours, you know, dancing, all that kind of thing. We're not really following that. We're kind of doing our own thing. We're just being ourselves, you know. We self-confess that we can't dance, and you know, we are a little bit rough around the edges, but maybe that's the appeal.
You're only here in Canada, in Montreal especially, as you said, for like hours, not even a day?
Yeah, we go to LA tonight, yeah.
When the fans all want to know, when do you plan on coming back for a real show at the Bell Centre, probably?
I am not 100% sure. I know that we are playing some shows in Canada, but I can't remember off the top of my head the dates.
What's next for you? What do you think has yet to come?
So in a couple of days we've got the Nickelodeon Kids' Choice Awards, which is going to be fun. We're performing there. Then we've got our North American tour, and then after that it's just like recording the second album. We need to get back into everyone
this
says
one
that.
Just dropped and you're already planning for a second.
Well,
one.
You've got to record, you know, a month in advance, because I mean, for this we must have recorded about 80 tracks, you know, to get into a 11-12 track album. So
the song that made you popular is called What Makes You Beautiful. What is the first thing you notice on a girl?
For me, it's if she's confident and has a good sense of humor.
Are you the one that makes her laugh, or do you like the girl that makes you laugh?
No, I like to make a girl laugh, yeah. It's about my only pickup, so I think I can do it, really.
I'm pretty sure it's working damn well.
Thank you.
What are your main influences when it comes to boy band?
Well, when I was growing up, I was a massive fan of Robbie Williams. Just the way that he performed always amazed me. He could just like captivate an audience like in a second.
Being from the UK, are there any big differences you noticed when you arrived here in America?
I just think the people are different, not in a good way, not in a bad way. Like, it's just different. I can't put my finger on it. It really interests me. Like, as sad as it sounds, like, different cultures quite interest me. And just because we speak the same language, it's like people's mannerisms are quite different. People seem a lot more chatty over here. Like, you go down the street and people, you know, be like, hi, what a lovely day it is, you know, all that kind of thing. Whereas, I don't know, in Britain, it's kind of just like, hi, you're right. You know what I mean? It's a bit more.
You're welcome anytime.